Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Surrender and let go of the past. This is a great card. Whatever life takes away from you, let it go. When you surrender and let go of the past, your life starts to be fully alive in the moment. Letting go of the past means that you can enjoy the dream that is happening right here, right now. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 139, NASDAQ is up 45. S&P is up 750, gold contract down 260, trading at 1772 an ounce. Silver up 21 cents, $17.88 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 75 cents, trading $38.76 a barrel. Notes and bonds, we have the 10-year flat, 138.27. The 30-year up 8 ticks at 178.03. And King Dollar, King Dollar's up 231 ticks, trading 97.374. The euro is at 112, the yen is at 107.22, and the British pound, folks, is at 124 to 1 US dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do we got out here? Well, you ride them cowboy, man. When I say ride them cowboy, ride them cowboy. We go take a look at the lows to the highs right before I got on the air. Bottom line, you were down 3 or 4 points inside the S&Ps. That baby pops about 10 to 12 points. And we'll see whether that market is going to hold as that is trying to get to higher price. The bulls and bears have been fighting all day long trying to get to higher price. It got the pop. There's no two ways about that. We just popped over the full consolidation that was out there. The top of that consolidation thus far was 3,056. Now, what we did out here, folks, we just popped to 3,059. And we'll see whether it can basically get up and over. It's 3,056 that it has to stay over. NDX 100, we go over to the NDX, we take a look at the NDX. You're gonna see the same situation inside the NDX. Bottom line, NDX 100 right now, that's trading up 19 points. Right now you get it at actually 22. Now the differential, and this happened this morning too, folks, which is pretty cool to understand. The differential is that the NDX 100, which has been the strongest indice, did not, and it also did not get to the highs over the consolidation and this pop right now. And the highs that we're talking about in the NDX 100 today is 10,048. This pop just got us to a price point of 10,039 or 10,031. So guess what? It's going to be a ride-em cowboy coming right into the close out here also. Of course, the bulls are going to try to jam this baby as high as you can get it. The fight's been going on all day. Basically, the bears are going to basically try to get this baby back into the red. Gold contract out here. What do we have with the gold contract? Sideways move out here today inside the gold market. You're down 240. You've traded 145,000 contracts. You're trading 1772. Silver, different ball game. Silver, bottom line, caught a bid out here. It's going to be interesting coming into a Friday. Silver caught the bid, got down to 1750, rejected lower price, trading 1788 right now. That baby, you know, sideways move in general, but bottom line, they couldn't slam it lower. And if we do go over to King Dollar, it's going to be really intriguing watching how King Dollar is going to trade out. The reason being is that what we had out here is this. The last swing high in King Dollar was an anemic bounce off the lows. We got to a price point of 97,739. We hit 97.597 today, and it can't seem to hold price. If we go over to the euro and we take a look at the euro, what you're going to see with the euro out here, which is the largest weighting structure, the euro rejected 1.1191, and right now you're at 1.1222. That is saying that I suspect what we're going to have coming in through the Friday, which is always important, is that more than likely we're going to have the euro go north once again, and the dollar goes south. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here, and this will be a low volume market out here today, folks. You get American Airlines off 35 cents. You get United up a buck. We get Norwegian up 61 cents. Boeing's down $3. You get Marbel up 27 cents. Spirit is up 9 cents. T-Mobile is up 233 inside the NDX 100. The strength versus the weakness inside the NDX 100. You have the strength out here is DocuSign is up 2.7%. Workday is up 2.7. You have Dollar Tree up 2.6. And Cognizant Technology is up 2.3. Taken away from it. Ross Stores down 3.4. You get Alta Salon up 3.3. You have Exelon Corporation off 3, and you get Fox off 2.8. After the close, we're going to have Nike come out with numbers after the close. Right now, Nike's trading up 92 cents, $100.99. Nike is going to be looking to take in $7.4 billion to their top line. It's quite a drop down. You know, bottom line is that they arrange their numbers. They've been taking in $10 billion in 90 days. This quarter, they're looking for $7.4 billion, and then they're looking for 9 cents to their bottom line versus the normal 78 cents. If we do take a look at Nike and see how this baby's set up, on a weekly bottom line, it looks like it actually can go higher. You know, we're at 100, that's 104 bucks. That actually is game. So we'll see when that comes out, and they will come out at 4:15 Eastern Standard Time. Dow Industrials right now, you're up 152. If we take a look at the strength inside the Dow, it was Goldman Sachs this morning. Let's see what we have out here. Still Goldman. Goldman Sachs is putting 50 positive points into the Dow. You get United Health putting 31, JP Morgan 20. Taken away from it. Boeing 21 negative, McDonald's 16, Home Depot 14, and Disney 11. Disney's not going to be opening there at Disneyland. They postponed that. That was going to be opened sometime in July. Dow Industrials up right now, up 150. NASDAQ up 44. S&P's up 6.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.